Hey guys, Jay here. Welcome back to another workshop video, where today we're gonna talk about
impact frames.
Low testing 1, 2, 3.
Okay. First of all, this video is going to be a lengthy one, so we've included timestamps for those who want to get straight to the point with editing either in After Effects or DaVinci. Still here? Okay then. So, what are impact frames? A lot of people think they're just black and white flashes that make a punch look cooler, and yeah, that's part of it. So, they're basically these multiple, sometimes a single frame that makes the movement feel more powerful, more real, let's say. But here's the thing, they're not just eye candy. Impact frames are a visual tool designed to manipulate perception. You're actually tricking the brain into feeling the hit more than just seeing it. Light also plays a huge role in all this. Like, take this shot here for example. See how the characters react to the lights around them? Yeah, they make the scene look dramatic, but also, they're visual cues telling your brain to feel the moment of impact. That's why impact frames are so fun to watch. Especially when there's some creativity going on. Here's another scene example. It feels like the red light is coming out of the character, and a few frames later, ice suddenly pops up from the ground. I can't say too much about the intention of this scene, though from the looks of it, you can use light and color creatively in these frames. Not only to shock the viewer, but sometimes even to convey a bit of that extra information or a mini story in the blink of an eye. Okay, but after watching it for a while now, I can't help but wonder, what usually comes first? A moody black frame or a flashy white one?
Well, it depends. The first frame can be white, a sudden flash to grab attention. Then black follows to reinforce the contrast and weight of the impact. The white frame mimics energy or light bursting out, while the black frame represents the moment of the aftershock.
Right. And if you want a build-up approach, starting with a dark frame helps crank up the tension. It's perfect for things like charging up or powering through a move.
Interesting.
Fuck out of my mouth.
Well, I guess we can go ahead and show how we create them.
All right, let's begin. The first thing I want to point out is that we usually work in 24 frames per second. It keeps things simple and helps avoid dealing with unnecessary extra frames. That said, it's totally up to you. 60 frames per second can look a lot smoother. But it takes a lot of effort to adjust every frame just to make the effect noticeable. Now let's start adding the impact effects. Create an adjustment layer and apply the tint effect to turn it black and white. For this scene, our character stomps on the ground, so we need to sync the impact frame to the right timing. Next, add fine edges. This makes the outlines pop. After that, apply a radial blur and set the type to zoom. In the Center tab, place the radial blur where you want the impact to focus. Then you can adjust the blur intensity to your liking. Now, bring in CC threshold and tweak the settings until you get the effect you want. What this effect does is that it turns your image into pure black and white, based on how bright each pixel is. If you increase the threshold, fewer pixels are bright enough to stay white, so the image gets darker. If you lower the threshold, more pixels turn white, making the image look brighter. It's an easy way to boost contrast and get a sharper look. Alright, let's move to the next frame and cut the adjustment layer. We'll invert the CC threshold, switching the white areas to black. Now move forward 2 frames, cut the adjustment layer again. This time, we'll disable the invert checkbox. Let's hit play and check it out. And there it is. A simple and effective impact frame.
Mm-hmm. And for those of you working in a different software, here's how we pulled off something similar using DaVinci Resolve. Alright, let's boot it up and dive in. Before we jump in, let's talk about frame rate, because it really does affect your workflow. We usually go with 24 FPS since it gives us fewer frames to deal with when timing those quick impact shots. Sure, 60 FPS looks smoother, but do you really want to tweak a ton of frames just to sell one punch? I don't know about you, but I'd rather keep it quick and easy. Okay, cool. Let's get this rolling. Once you've got your footage ready in the edit page, drop an adjustment clip onto the timeline. Scrub to the spot where you want the impact to hit, then trim the clip down to the length you want for the effect. Now, head over to the Fusion page, and time for some node magic. Start with a color corrector node, and drop the saturation all the way to 0 to get that black and white look. Next, add edge detect and tweak the settings until those outlines really stand out. Then bring in a directional blur. Set the type to zoom and adjust the length and glow to your liking. Also, be sure to move the center axis to where the impact is bursting from. Want a bit of that grungy look? Add grain to the chain and dial in the power to your taste. So here's where it gets interesting. Add a bitmap node and set the channel to luminance. What this does is take your black and white image and convert it into a high contrast mask based on brightness. When you adjust the low and high thresholds, you're deciding which parts of the image to show up in the final output. Lower values let in more gray areas, while tighter values make it punchier. And if you want to flip it, just take the invert checkbox right here. Once it looks the way you wanted, go back to the edit page and boom, effects applied. Now, let's animate it. Move forward 1 frame in the timeline. Make a cut on the adjustment clip, then hop back into Fusion. This time, untick the invert box. Back in Edit, go forward 2 more frames, make another cut and repeat the process. And just like that, impact frames done! There's definitely other ways to do this, but hopefully this gives you a starting point to explore and build your own style.
That's the fun part, because you can get real creative with this. No, sorry to cut you off, Boro. I just want to point out something real quick. Here's an example from our past Arcadian video. As you can see, there's a lot of stuff happening in these frames. But they're not just random flashes. They're layered with different effects. Some of them even help convey the skill's definition, like... What was it again?
Having no luck.
Serpent's Ire! Yeah, that's the one! While we look closely, the effect creates these intricate, scale-like patterns. It's almost like the scales are a subtle reference to the skill. Huh, maybe that's the connection. Anyway, the main point is, you don't have to stick to the classic black and white look for impact frames. You've got room to get creative with texture, color, and shape to reflect what's actually happening in the scene. As long as it hits hard and supports the story, it's doing its job. But for now.
Thank you for watching.
And have fun creating, everyone.
finally. Time for some payback.
You ready for this?
Get yourselves ready. So what you're saying is to start recording and don't stop recording.
Yes, and like then, an improv, you know?
Then, okay.
Impact! Flames!
I've not done this since I was a kid.
But they're not just random effects. They're layered with different effects. I said that line wrong.
Is that it turns your images into pure black and white. Based on the...
Cut.
What this effect does is that it turns your image... Why did this have to be at the end of the day, after I ate f***ing pasta?
Come on, you got this. Arise.
I don't think that's the lie.
Kamehame!
What the hell is happening?
I'm actually talking like a Final Fantasy character as I do this. I'm like doing the hands up, two hand up and down thing and putting my hands on my hips as I finish talking. I can't believe it.
The aftershock. Aftershock. Aftershocks.
You're stirring, you good man?
Buddy, we got aftershocks on this here. Buddy!
Oh, I forgot to tell y'all. We now have an official Patreon. We have a few things to offer right now. From sneak peeks and receiving assets for your future projects, all made by the lovely noob adventurer and crew. Also, your name will get featured at the end of each video. So click the link in the description and support the Magitek crew today. I can't, because I live in Eorzean. Gil can't transfer to cash. So, yeah. Mind paying for me? Nope, hey, I wasn't asking for anybody to, you know, give me money.